Hello plant friends, Adina here from Plants Equals Happiness. In today's video, I wanted to show you a few of the hoyas that they bloom for me. And I have beautiful, beautiful flowers. So I can dry them in silica gel and I can put them in my art, especially earrings or keychain or book marks as well. This is my Hoya Javanica and look how beautiful the flowers are. Absolutely stunning, stunning, stunning flowers. And Hoya Javanica is also known of shooting star Hoya. Look at those flowers. Absolutely gorgeous. Beautiful, beautiful Hoya. The second one that is next to me, it's my Hoya Bella. And my Hoya Bella bloomed for me. Look. Oh my God, it's full of blooms. They are absolutely, absolutely beautiful. And I'm gonna dry them in silica gel and I'm gonna put them in my art as well. Look how beautiful they are. Very, very nice. And as you can see, my Hoya Bella is so beautiful and lush. And it's full of flowers, as you can see. I absolutely love, 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 love this Hoya. I watered this Hoya, so is a little bit wet. I'm gonna do some reporting and I'm gonna announce the winners. Thank you very much because I hit 200 subscribers and you subscribe to my channel and you like my videos. And the winner of the Syngonium confetti is Lifeaholic. So, as you can see, there is a leaf on her way. So, this Syngonium confetti has a lot of roots, so I'm gonna ship it to Lifeaholic. She always watch my videos and she always leave a very beautiful comments. The pair of earrings, the winner is Dominica, and I can't wait to send it to her because she's a Hoya lover like me. So the earrings, they have Hoya obovada, as you can see, and fern. Beautiful, beautiful earrings. Plantifolia, she won a keychain, and in this keychain I have Echeveria blooms. So I'm gonna send it to her. Cactus keychain as well. So the winner of the cactus keychain is Erica. And a bookmark with woodland flowers. And the lady who won the bookmark with woodland flowers is gardening with Git Kumar. So I'm going to let them know and I'm going to send it to them. Thank you very much for subscribing and thank you very much for like my videos. And I will carry on to do what I love. I will show you my Syngonium Wendy Landii. Hello, Amelia. Come here. Sit down. Good girl. This is a very, very beautiful Syngonium. As you can see, it has like a white stripe in the middle of the leaf. Absolutely gorgeous. I love, 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 love this Syngonium. Beautiful, beautiful Syngonium. And I place it in water to get more to roots. And then I think I'm gonna transfer to soil. I can see some roots. The next one that I'm going to show you, it's my Philodendron Painted Lady. I never thought that this Philodendron Painted Lady is going to recover, but she did. Look at the new leaf, and I can't wait for the new leaf to emerge, and I can't wait for the new leaf to form as well. It's a beautiful, beautiful Philodendron Painted Lady. I had such a headache with the Philodendron Painted Lady, but I have another one in water, and as you can see, and it has, I hope you can see, and it has a new leaf. Look how beautiful it is. Absolutely gorgeous. Very, very, very nice. And I'm really happy This one rooted so well, and there is one leaf on the way. Very, very happy. The next one, I don't know if you have codex plants in your collection, but I do. This is a Stephania erectia codex plant. It's my first codex plant, and it was in soil for quite a long time, and to be honest with you, didn't happen. So nothing happened, so I put it in Leca, and look how beautiful the codex. It looks like a potato. And I put it in Leca, so now I'm waiting for her to form roots, then I'm gonna transfer to soil. Fingers crossed, I'm gonna see this Stephania erecta having leaves. I don't know if you know, but the leaves, they're absolutely beautiful, beautiful, beautiful leaves. They are more like a round shape, and I can't wait for this Stephania erecta to get roots and of course to have leaves. I keep this Stephania erecta under cloche because I know she loves humidity, so...
Bye!
So until it's getting rooted, I'm gonna leave it under a cloche. The next one, which I never thought that she was going to come back, this is my Calathea White Fusion. But it's so beautiful, look. Look at the leaves, absolutely gorgeous, and you can see the new growth as well. And I can't wait for this Calathea White Fusion to get more leaves. Absolutely beautiful, beautiful, beautiful Calathea. And as you can see, the soil, it's very, very wet. So I think the Calathea White Fusion loves the soil to be moist all the time. So let's do some reporting. With this Hoya Bella blooms, I don't know if you can see, I'm gonna dry them, and of course I'm gonna put them in epoxy resin material so I can have earrings and bookmarks, and I think I'm gonna do book covers as well, notebook covers as well. I can't wait to just take the blooms. They're absolutely beautiful, but they don't really last very long. They last for like 2 weeks or 3 weeks. So after that, I'm going to dry them and put them in my art. So now, let's do some reporting, and I want to talk about how you root your Hoya. There are many, many ways to root your Hoya. You can root a Hoya in soil, which I think everybody loves that. As you can see, this is Hoya Mathilde, and it's rooting in soil. Oh, hello, Amelia. And you can see it's doing very, very well. Or you can root a Hoya in Leca. It's up to you. I have my Hoya cultivar Michelle, so it's in Leca at the moment. As you can see, this leaf doesn't have roots yet, but for sure is going to have. As you can see, this Hoya cultivar Michelle is in Leca. This leaf is doing very well, and I can see a growth point. I don't know if you can see, but there is a growth point, so I can wait for this Hoya to grow. So in soil, in Leca, you can root a Hoya in Ceramis as well. I had a problem with Hoya Stoniana. I had it in soil, and to be honest with you, the leaves, they were a little bit wrinkly. So I put that Hoya, I took it out from the soil and put it in Ceramis, and now it's doing very, very well. I'm sure the roots, they are absolutely beautiful. And I bought some ceramic pots because I love to keep Hoya in ceramic pots, because it doesn't matter if you overwater them, the ceramic is going to absorb the excess water. So let's start reporting. I'm gonna turn the camera. Yeah, So the first one that I'm going to report, it's Hoya Mapijera. So Hoya Mapijera, as you can see, it has two beautiful leaves, and I hope it's going to get more. The soil that I'm going to use is the same soil. It's cocoa coir or cocoa peat, ceramis, vermiculite, and of course I use cinnamon as well. So Hoyas, they were gonna have the new home. Because I think it's already the time for them to be reported in ceramic pots. Look how beautiful it is, absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. So this is Hoya Mapijera. Yes, Mapijera. So this is the first one. The second one that I'm going to report, it's my Hoya Louisbois. Look how beautiful it is. Hoya Bella Louisbois. So it's growing really beautiful, this Hoya Louisbois. Look how beautiful it is. It's really, really beautiful. And Hoya Bella in general is growing really fast as well. So the third one that I'm going to report, it's Hoya Hippolacea. As you can see, it's a very, very beautiful Hoya. The leaves, they are very fuzzy. I want you to report this Hoya for a very long time. But now it has her turn. It has a new growth, but it's a very, very, very slow grower. Sorry. Look how beautiful it is, absolutely gorgeous. Oh my God, I don't know what is wrong with me today. So this is Hoya Hippolacea. It's a very, very slow grower, very, very slow. I don't know why. Okay, the next one. Is my Hoya Mimerkopa, big leaves. And you can see the new growth and absolutely happy. Because this one, every time when I water, I don't know, it gave me yellow leaves and really, really frustrates me so bad. But now I can see it has two new leaves, and I'm really, really happy. Look how beautiful it is. This is a very, very beautiful Hoya. So this is Hoya Mimerkopa big leaves. Absolutely beautiful. Very, very nice. So I'm really, really happy because I repot them in a ceramic pot. The next one, this is a beautiful as well, Hoya Cagayanensis. Look how beautiful it is. So I'm gonna transfer her in a ceramic pot as well. Because I notice if they stay in those small plastic cups, they get dry really, really quick. So this is Hoya Cagayanensis. And I have to repot Hoya latifolia. Look at that beautiful leaf, absolutely beautiful. And this is the dinner plate Hoya, which it gets very, very big leaves. I can wait the new growth to see what kind of leaves they are going to emerge. I think they are going to be very, very big. I'm going to transfer my Hoya Gunungading. Look how beautiful the leaves are, absolutely gorgeous, very, very beautiful. If this Hoya gets sun stress, it has like a very red tint to the leaves. And this Hoya was for a very, very long time in that I want to see, yeah, it has roots, and I'm really, really happy that it has roots. Look how beautiful it is, absolutely gorgeous, very, very nice. And I want to transfer in a big ceramic pot. And of course, I'm gonna pin it down because it doesn't really stick to the soil. So it's very, very beautiful. I love, love, love this Hoya. So this is Hoya Gunungading. Very, very nice. It has like, it gets a red tint when it's stressed from the sun. Sorry. The next one, this is a very beautiful Hoya, and I can't wait to transfer. It's Incrassada Moon Shadow. Look how beautiful it is. Look at the new growth as well. Absolutely gorgeous. This is a beautiful, beautiful Hoya. You can see the leaves. They are very, very dark green. Absolutely gorgeous. Very, very nice. Beautiful, beautiful Hoya to have in your collection. And I'm gonna transfer to soil in this ceramic planter. Very, very nice. And then I'm gonna water them. Absolutely beautiful. I'm gonna water them with my fertilizer, Alaska fish fertilizer. I'm going to carry on report them. Thank you very much for subscribing and like my videos. Adina Kikero, Plants Equals Happiness. My YouTube channel, it's all about houseplants, common or rare. Hoyas that are my number one passion, cactus, succulents, planters and pots. Thank you very much for supporting my channel. See you in my next video. Have a lovely day. Bye.